The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Amen, amen. Yeah. Amen. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. He's kept us all week. He supplied all of our needs.
Amen.
We're all still here. He kept us safe. We're not sick. We just thank Him for that. Thank good to see Ron here today. Amen.
Yeah.
Let's give the Lord a round of applause.
Yeah.
We prayed for you last week, and now you're here this week. So.
Yes.
The Lord is really, truly answering our prayers.
Yes.
We can see that with our own eyes.
Yes.
And that is awesome, awesome.
We've been checking on Him.
Yeah, amen.
Yeah.
Anybody have any praise reports or testimonies? They're like a shed.
Where'd you go for Shannon?
I just want to thank and praise God for being in His house today. Thank and praise God how He takes care of us and He keeps us in the midst of every situation. Thank and praise God how once you get into that relationship with Him, He begins to just minister to your heart
Amen.
And to your mind in such
Amen.
A way that it's just hard to even explain. He's just so good, and I just thank Him for His tender mercies and His loving kindness and how He just keeps me day by day.
Amen.
I thank Him for all that He's done in my life and what He's doing in other lives around me. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen. God is awesome. He is omnipresent. He's
amen.
Everywhere at the same time.
Amen.
Amen. Anybody else?
I should be.
Deb?
Yeah, I'm gonna start going to tutor now, so I can read more.
Amen, amen. She's starting to go to tutor classes, so she
again
be able to read more. All right.
Amen. I don't know where to go. He got a verses for me. We working on it. Plus a story where he got one book and stuff, and we start reading that on a paper. Then we had to finish it this Wednesday.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Dolores.
I want to praise God and thank Him for whenever I have something that's burdened me down, I can take it. One day I had such a burden, and I said, this is too much. I can't handle it. And I heard the Holy Spirit say to me, cast your burdens on the Lord.
Amen.
And I said, oh, Jesus, I don't want to cast this on you. And He said, I can handle it.
Amen.
And I said, yes, you can. I give it to you. And from that moment on, that burden left me. And now, whenever something comes and I get anxious about something, the devil comes at me in such a way, I say, Lord, I can't handle this myself, but I know You can handle it, and I'm going to cast this on You. And just like that, it's gone.
Amen.
And but you have to faith.
Amen.
Faith.
Amen.
Jesus.
Awesome.
And I thank God.
Amen. We must cast all our burdens unto the Lord.
Yeah.
We're not built to carry all of our burdens like that. So we cast them unto the Lord, and then we have to have faith that He will take care of it all.
Amen.
Amen. Anybody else?
Yeah, I want to thank God. Just an honor to be back in His house again.
Amen.
Just pray for me and my friend Mary. Her sister just had surgery. And she wanted you guys to keep her in prayer.
Amen. Amen. God is truly moving. Amen. He answers our prayers because we prayed for you last week and you're here today.
That's a blessing.
That's a blessing. And we thank God for that. I'd just like to thank God for keeping me safe, keeping my family safe, supplying all our needs. I just thank him for that. I can't thank him enough.
Amen.
You know, I don't even know the words sometimes to say. You know, so I just hum songs sometimes. I just love the Lord with all my heart.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, today's devotional that I was given is about the Holy Spirit. It says, picture this. You're on a road trip and you're mindlessly scrolling through Instagram with music blaring through your headphones. Suddenly you pass through the middle of nowhere and you lose your cell phone signal. Sure enough, Spotify cuts out, the music stops, your feed is frozen, and you're left to your own thoughts. No music, no more texting. In the midst of your technological desolation, you remember the car has a radio. With the tap of a button, music fills your car. Radios feel like magic. In desolate places where smartphones are useless, a reliable old radio can tap into the invisible signals around us and fill our silence with music. At the turn of a knob, you can shuffle from singer to singer. Maybe even mix a little country in. Maybe not. No dead batteries, just voices pulled from thin air. The Holy Spirit feels sort of magical too. Maybe even a little spooky. He's everywhere. He's watching you listen to me read this right now. The air around you is filled with the invisible noise of God's voice. And like a radio, you were built to hear it and relay his thoughts to people through your own words and actions. Most people miss this, but God wants to speak to you. Did you catch that? He wants to speak to you, and he built you to hear his voice. He doesn't usually speak out loud, but his voice comes from inside of you. It takes practice to learn how to separate your own thoughts from his voice. And different people hear him in different ways. Sometimes the Holy Spirit sounds like thoughts in your head. Sometimes he drops in mental pictures. Other times he gives you a dream that just feels different. Most often he speaks by illuminating parts of the Bible, reminding you of a verse you've read, and helping you understand it in a new way. When Jesus promised he would never leave us alone, the Holy Spirit was that fulfillment of that promise. When you become a Christ follower, the Holy Spirit moves in. We become his house. So when he speaks, his voice comes from inside you. What if all this time you've been hearing his voice without recognizing it? So when you're driving through life and your journey leads you to a dark place where you feel alone and abandoned, know that you're never really alone. Even when nothing else seems to work, the Holy Spirit is right there with you. With only a thought, he can speak life, hope, strength, joy, and encouragement to you and over you. Even better, if you learn to listen intently He can help you avoid some of those dark places. Amen.
Amen.
We have to listen and hear God's voice.
Amen.
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 So sometimes I know when I pray, I'll pray, and right at the end of my prayer, I just get up and start moving around. I don't sit there and listen and wait for an answer. I just get up and go. So I have to start learning to sit there in quiet sometime and just listen and wait for the Lord to respond. He's going to respond. Amen. We just got to take that time to listen. Amen. Amen. I'm ready to praise the Lord in a song. Are you? If I can have the praise and worship team come up. Amen. Amen. Those of you who can stand, if you would like to stand as we sing praises to our King. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. Okay, well.
Holy, this is holy. Lord God, the way you do.
We thank you for your love, and we thank you for the Holy Spirit that you have given us, Lord God. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 making a decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white, turn to color all around. All is new in the Savior I have found. This is living now.
Am I living it? Do I live in it? So astounding. Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste and see. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. And still I saw my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. Yeah.
do the yellow lights do?
Yellow lights on the bus go blink, blink, blink. Blink, blink, blink. Blink, blink, blink. So when Jesus was think, think, think.
I need to slow down.
What does the arm on the bus do?
Arm on the bus puts sign out, so please don't pout. What is it about? It's keep kids safe on the bus route
each and every school day. What does the sign say?
Sign says stop, don't go around. You look like a clown, and everyone around. When the sign is out, don't just slow down. You must completely stop.
What if there's a median?
The opposite way with the median. No need to stop, but please still watch. The rules have changed, but then again, we want to keep kids safe.
What did we learn?
The buses are here for the school year.
So make sure you think, slow down for the blink. When the sign goes out, don't move about.
Is brought to you by the City of Burnsville. For more information about traffic laws and bus safety, please visit www.burnsville.org/traffic.
Our God is an awesome God. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. Oh, you don't know like I know what he's done for me. The first one is Psalms 42. Psalms 42, verse 5. Psalms 42, verse 5. Hallelujah. Oh, God, you're so good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's the joy of my salvation. Yes, he is. He's the lily of the valley. Yes, he is. He woke me early this morning, and he started me on my way. He's the joy of my salvation. Yes, he is. Hallelujah. I thank you, God, for being the joy of my salvation. And when you find this psalm, please stand for the reading of God's word. Psalms 42, hallelujah, verse 5. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, I bless your holy name. Thank you, God, for being the head of my life. Yes, God. Before I get into the word today, I do want to say that today will be, this service means so much to me. I have a surgery coming up tomorrow, and so I won't be in front of you for a few weeks, between 4 to 6 weeks. I thank God for another man of God that will be standing in my place, in my seat, until I return to the pulpit. I'm seeking your prayers. I'm seeking those of you who know how to pray for me during this time, that I will have a speedy recovery. The doctor say 4 to 6 weeks, but my God can bring me back sooner than that, and I know he can. So I'm praying right now in the name of Jesus that God will be there, praying for the doctors as they work on my body, that they will be led of God to do what they have to do for me. I thank you right now for your prayers. Lane, is this on? Psalms 42, verse 5. And it says, why, my soul, why are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. And then the other one is Psalms 118, verses 1 through 8. Psalms 118, verses 1 through 8. Psalms 118, verses 1 through 8. And it says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let Israel now say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron now say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord now say, his mercy endures forever. I call on the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a broad place. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me? The Lord is for me among those who help me. Therefore, I shall see my desire on those who hate me. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. May God add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, and to the doing of his word. You may be seated. All week long, I've been praying, and these two psalms came into my heart and into my mind. And then there was a song that I used to sing at a church I was attending, and it was, don't wait till the battle is over. Shout now. Because you know in the end, you're going to win. The scriptures that God showed me encouraged me not to worry or be concerned with the cares of this world or with the daily setbacks I was coming here, the Lord was ministering to my heart. And a lot of people are walking around in fear about what's going to happen, in fear about this pandemic, in fear every day. They can't even move hardly because fear has gripped them. And I'm talking about people who are Christians. They are in fear. And the Lord spoke to me and he said, fear and faith can't be in the same place. You're either going to fear that what God is going to do, or you're going to have faith in what God is going to do. Fear of what the devil is doing can't walk and can't stay in the same place that God's faith is. If you have faith in God, it will eradicate fear in anything that man or anything that the devil will do in your life. And that faith in God will eradicate the fear that the enemy is trying to put upon you. As I've said before, a pastor said to me, fear, F-E-A-R. That's false evidence appearing real. It's not real. So we can't allow the things that the devil is putting in your natural sight to cause us to fear our future. If you are a child of God, your future was sealed on the cross. If you are a child of God, when Jesus died on that cross and he rose again with all power in his hand, your future was sealed in him. The moment that you accepted the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. So if you accepted him, what are you fearing? If you accepted him, these little battles that you're going through, what happened to your faith in God? What makes you downcast? As the scripture said, my soul, why are you downcast? Our soul should never be downcast. We should lift up our eyes unto the hill from which cometh our help, knowing that it comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. All of our help comes from the Lord. All we got to do is give it over. Give all of our fears, every situation over to God, and he will take care of it. As I said, we're going to go through little battles. And that's something that we're going to go through as long as we're down here on this earth. As long as Satan is still rolling around on this earth, we're going to go through little battles. But they're not going to be anything that's going to send us back to the place that we can't go forward. You know, if you think about a boomerang, if you're not a boomerang, but like that David, and he had that thing that he killed Goliath with. He had that in his hand, a slingshot. If you look at it, I saw this one where it was shaped like a Y, and it had the rubber on it. And when you pull it back, and even with the arrow, when you pull it back and you let it go, it's going to go forward at a force that is going to hit. Whatever it hit, it's going to penetrate. Well, look at your situation right now. You may be in a back situation. You may be in a setback situation. But if you put your faith in God, if you put your trust in God, when you are loose, when you are set out that situation, you're going to spring forth into a new dimension, stronger than you were before. All a setback does is prepare you to excel into a place that God would have you to go, in the name of Jesus. So don't let little setbacks keep you back. You allow it to help you to grow. He said, he that overcometh shall receive the kingdom. We've got to be overcomers. How do you overcome? If you overcome something, that means there was something that you was dealing with that you had to let go of in order to be an overcomer. We are overcomers in Christ Jesus. So none of these situations that we're dealing with, none of the things that we're going through right now should keep us in a place that we don't trust God and have faith in his ability to bring us out. In the name of Jesus, we got to come forth. Hallelujah. In 2 Timothy in chapter 2, verse 3 and 4, it says, you then hardship as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No one engaged in warfare entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who entrusted him as a soldier. All of us that are Christians, we've enlisted in the armed forces of the Most High God. Our commander-in-chief, God, has sent forth his generals. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit has been sent forth to give us directions and guidance on which way to go and how to go, which way to live and how to live. All we got to do is follow the instructions that has been given by our commander-in-chief to our generals to help us to go through any situation, any battle that we endure. We can make it through if we trust God, if we allow the Holy Spirit to direct us in the way God would have us to go. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. God has sent the Holy Spirit to direct our path. Any good soldier will follow the instructions that they've been given so that they can come through victorious. No good soldier that I know that's enlisted in God's army is going to go off on his own to do anything. I remember a pastor said one time, we can't do it by ourselves. Hallelujah. You think about a bunch of bananas. They're all together. They're all connected together. But which one gets peeled is the one that leaves the bunch that gets peeled. The banana that leaves the bunch gets peeled. We as children of God, if we stay united together, if we allow the Holy Spirit to direct us, the devil cannot peel us. He cannot penetrate what God has put there. He cannot penetrate our armor if we trust in God, if we have faith in him, if we allow the Holy Spirit to lead us and direct us. The devil cannot penetrate what God has given us. The only way he can get to us is we allow him. And you might say, how do we allow the devil to get to us when we have a lack of faith? When we take off our armor and lay it to the side, when we begin to allow what we see with our natural eyes dictate what we do, when we begin not to have love for our fellow man, when we begin to lie, cheat, and steal, or believe in liars, cheaters, and stealers, when we allow whatever the devil has placed in front of us to get into our minds, then it gets into our hearts, and then we act upon what the devil is saying instead of listening to the Holy Spirit, instead of listening to the Father, reading his word. As Lane said earlier, once we pray, instead of jumping up and going on about our business, wait to hear a response from the Lord. Allow God to minister to our hearts and minds on what he wants us to do and how he wants us to do it. Don't speak until the Lord tells you to speak. So many times we open our mouths and we flap our lips at it's time when we need to be still and be quiet so that we can hear what the Spirit is saying. So when we speak, we'll be speaking what the Word of God requires and calls for us to speak, and not out of our own emotion. See, our flesh can become emotional. We can say and do things that's not of God. We can act in ways that's not like God. But if we allow the Holy Spirit to lead us, to direct us, to guide us, to speak through us, so that when we speak out of our mouths, we're speaking according to the will of God. Everything will be different. Everything will be all right. The Lord said, the same Spirit that raised him from the dead lives in us. That means we have those of us that accept the Lord Jesus as our Lord and Savior. That means the Holy Spirit lives inside of us. That means we should be living according to the life that is living inside of us. We should be living a holy life. We should be living a kind-hearted life. We should be living a compassionate life. We should be living a life that exudes love to our fellow man, that exudes love to God our Father. If we're living according to the Spirit that lives inside of us, if we speak, when we speak, we should be speaking in accordance to the Spirit that's living inside of us. Because whatever comes out of our mouth, God said no word would come out of his mouth and come back void. It was accomplished what has been set out to do. So if we speak in accordance to the love of God, we'll get love in return. Because God is love. And if we're children of God, then we need to be children that's filled with the love of Jesus Christ in our hearts, in our minds. We should be unified together on one accord so that we can live in accordance to what the Spirit is saying. Don't wait till the battle that you're dealing with is over. Shout now. Sing praises to God now. Lift him up now. Praise his holy name now. Worship him now. Even in the midst of your turmoil, in the midst of your hardships, in the midst of your situations, give your life to God now. Trust him now. Believe in him now. With all of us that say that we're children of the Most High God, my Bible says one could put 1,000 to flight. Two could put 10,000 to flight. I'm talking about demons. One could put 1,000 demons to flight. That means they'd be out of your life. Two could put 10,000 to flight. What about the millions of us who profess that we're children of God? If we come together on one accord and pray and bind the hand of the enemy off of our lives, off of our families, off of our country, off of our universe, we'll come in and we can put to flight. The devil cannot destroy what God has put on this earth if we come together in one accord. We must come together. We must live in accordance to what God would desire for us to live. We must have faith instead of fear. The only thing we need to fear is not living the way God would have us to live. But we should not fear anything the devil tries to do if we're children of God. We have to have the faith that can move mountains. A mustard seed faith. It don't take much. But you got to believe. If there's anyone out there that has not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you want to be in God's army, and I'm going to tell you, being a child of God, the Holy Spirit lives in you, so there's power in you. The enemy is going to be angry at you because you turn your life away from him and to God. So you might go through a few battles, but know you're not in the battle alone. God is with you. He'll never leave you or forsake you. If you want to give your life over to God, there's a simple prayer that you need to pray along with me. And I want you to pray these words after me. Say, Heavenly Father, forgive me for all of my sins. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. I believe Jesus died, was buried, pity me. If you prayed that prayer in sincerity, you are now a child of God. And I encourage you to get around other believers so that they can encourage you in your life and in your walk with the Father. I pray that you find a Bible-believing, Bible-teaching, Bible-practicing church so that you may grow in the Word of God. West Main Street Church of the Nazarene is here for you. If you're on Facebook and you want to get a hold of us, we're right here in Fort Wayne, Indiana. This is a praying church. This is a praying and believing church. We pray God hears, He answers. So if you need somebody to encourage you, we're here for you. Facebook us, inbox me, whatever. I'm here for you. If you're a child of God and you know that things haven't been right in your life and you haven't really been living like God would have you to live, or you've been allowing fear to get in your way, that false evidence that appears real, then you also contact us. We don't put anybody down. We pray for you to build you up. And we're here for you every day. Just contact us and we will be in prayer with you. I thank God for the opportunity that He has given for me to stand with you today. Keep me in your prayers. Encourage the pastor that will be with you through the month of September. Continue to be a part of this ministry. We need you as much as you need us. And we give God the glory. We're shouting now. I'm shouting now because my battle with my knee is over. And I'm shouting right now praises unto the Father for healing me. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Happy holidays from all of us at Parkview Health.
On the first day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me a hospital in my community. On the second day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me two acts of love and a hospital in my community. On the third day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me three true friends, two acts of love and a hospital in my community.
Sweetie.
9, doctors dancing 8, teenage swinging 7, trainers swinging 6, nurses swinging 5, medics with wings 4, healing cures 3, true friends 2, excellent love and a hospital in my community. On the 11th day of Christmas, my park you gave to me. 11 and inside 10, Texas swinging 9, doctors dancing 8, teenage swinging 7, trainers
I'm Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace.
My life.
my treasure. You the storm, you remain in control, and in the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Your love surrounds me in the eye of the storm. When the solid ground is falling out from underneath my feet, between the black skies and my red eyes, I can barely see. When I realize I've been sold out by my friends and my family, I can feel the rain reminding me. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Your love surrounds me in the eye of the storm. When my hopes and dreams are far from me and I'm running out of faith, I see the future I picture slowly fade away. And when the tears of pain and heartache are pouring down my face, I find my peace in Jesus' name. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Your love surrounds me. Doctor says I've only got a few months left. It's like a bitter pill I'm swallowing. I can barely take a breath. And when addiction steals my baby girl and there's nothing I can do, my only hope is to trust you. I trust you, Lord. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. You guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Your love surrounds me in the eye of the storm. You remain in control in the middle of the war. You guard my soul. You alone are the anchor when my sails are torn. Surrounds me.
gone, Lord.
When my flesh is failing, you're still holding on.
Oh,
when the storm is raging,
when the storm is raging,
my hope is gone.
No, my hope is gone.
When my flesh is failing,
my flesh is failing,
you're still holding on.
Great is he that is living.
Listen for the Lord. He'll tell you what to do.
Amen. Amen.